Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Kufuka bus, no jokes. You live one life, think thrice.
And of course, welcome back from that very short break. Yes, Coupon Scoop is proudly sponsored by Laka 3 Bet Chisoboka. 4 easy steps for you to become a millionaire.
Okay, I know that right now you're in a bad mood because of Balam.
Amen.
And I'm going to make your mood worse because of this whole thing. Politics in Uganda is under attack.
I will get off this set. Because there is one thing I want Ugandans to understand.
Yeah.
Just because you knew these people as entertainers doesn't mean the entertainer is evolving into a politician. Well, there are two different things.
There are two areas in Uganda that are under attack. And
the church and politics.
And politics. And they are winning. The fake people are winning. So
and feminists.
Feminists. Lord. Drum roll! Introducing the next short-circuited medulla oblongata, the major man of the evening!
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Diwande makwal Jose Chameleon.
Atake jatakwa tanyi.
Now, Jose Chameleon came out and he put that tweet up. This is the reasoning of a man that wants to lift up a community to be a leader. He actually said that the world population is about 9 billion people. Meaning, we have 9 billion options.
Wildfire.
First of all, Chameleon, when we say that there are 9 billion people on Earth, don't think that all those 9 people, some of them have medical conditions. Some of them are dying tomorrow because
chronic
they have cancer.
Diseases.
Some of them have Down
God
syndrome.
God has already planned they are dying in the
Thank
evening.
You. Some of them are like Sheila Kashumba.
Ooh.
What? I'm just have to be honest. What?
And
She's
then
an option.
Some of them are like Lydia Jasmine.
Some of them are like Mbonye. Some of them are like Professor Kakande. Some of them are like, we could name at least some.
Some of them are like you.
Me, I'm actually not that bad. Just that I like alcohol. But that's a minor weakness.
Is there anybody subscribe that?
Okay. Is there even a world leader that doesn't use drugs? I have never.
I actually think all world leaders.
There is no politician.
And I think, like, whenever I'm listening to their speeches, I'm always like.
Yeah. It's just that right now, it's just that these days are not apologetic about it. Because one of these days, trust me, a president somewhere is about to release selfies with cigars. If it hasn't yet happened, I haven't yet seen it.
Chilling. Yo, so, good life.
Chameleon, first of all, he's saying hashtag people power, then said wildfire.
What the hell is
put
wildfire?
Put up that thing. Produce, help us and put up.
Wait, but what does the wildfire mean? Go for?
Is that like some hashtag going on? The world population is about 9 billion. Uh-huh, we are following. People.
No, I'm still Maybe trying to understand. No, options. Let me use layman terms.
Yeah.
How does this photo and the caption go together? And if I am just going through my Twitter feed, and let's say
stuff.
I am not from Uganda, right?
Yeah.
And then I go through my Twitter feed and this comes on my TL.
Yeah.
How does that significantly
change. Let's look at this.
My thoughts.
Let's try to look at all the hidden messages in this picture. Because
there's no subliminal.
No, you know when you're high, your brain thinks so far.
No subliminal.
First of all, he put two flags. The one of Uganda. Oh, that's Ecuador. Oh, that's where? Oh, that's Bangladesh. Oh, that's Paraguay.
So,
secondly, he's saying people power. And he gets, is that a white woman, an Asian woman, or a mixed woman wearing a cape that is symbolic of a pressure group that is not yet even registered as a political party.
I'm glad you put it together. Say it for them slowly. It is
a pressure group. It is not a political
it's
party.
It's not a political
people.
Party.
People
it's
power.
Not even an ideology
People
anymore.
Power is not recognized under
anyway,
anything. It doesn't have
but
any political power.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Bobby Wine finally, I don't know why he always first waits to go to America to tell the Bazungu that he's standing and forgets to tell us first.
He's learning from
Matunu. We have been asking him for the longest time possible.
Yeah.
So are you finna stand? He's like, no, the people power. Yeah. And then he waits for a beautiful moment on Al Jazeera.
Yeah.
And he's like, yeah, I'm going to stand. I'm like, dude.
No. That is taken from the book of one of the most educated people who is called Olara Oturu. Now, Olara Oturu, when you see him, you really know that this man is a political mistake.
No, he's always like deer headlights.
Yeah, no.
He's the deer and the politics is like
So Olajuwon went to the north and people were shouting in the audience. And then he didn't know a comeback to handle a heckling audience. Then he was like, okay, I have listened to all your problems. I promise I am going to report President Museveni to the UN. He never went back to the North. And then he retired from politics. So a person like that.
Who shall?
Let me tell you something. The humor.
You're a chuckle.
You know, it has come to an extent whereby a person like Mabirizi, who was trying to be president.
Mabirizi.
Is no longer looking ridiculous.
He's
politics has become parody. The parody and the real thing have intertwined.
You've merged. Actually, whenever I look at our political scene in this country, I'm like, wait.
Yeah.
What are we going for now? I mean, I'm going to say this because the president said no one can actually take away his zen down. His last speech he gave. That last speech.
Yeah.
I was looking at my president like.
Yo, we're coming back to that. We're coming up to the president because the comedy is too much. Now, you think that Jose Chameleon has some funny type of weed? Now, I don't know who's, because let us not say that our president smokes. But I don't know if it's Don Wanyama.
What if
there is someone smoking at State House and the president is a passive smoker?
He's getting lit.
He's getting high on somebody else's weed. Because the president came out and he said this, quote.
Quote for quote.
I challenged a family recently, asking them how many pairs of bed sheets they have. A family must have at least 40 pairs of bed sheets.
Now, this is the part where I say, perhaps we got him out of context.
Really?
Or perhaps the story was longer than that, because when you just start it like that, I'm like, wait, what?
Our family must have at least 40 pairs of bed sheets.
Now you can't.
Which family is he talking about?
No, I think our president is OCD.
I think that if President Museveni wakes up in the middle of the night to go take a short call, he better find new sheets or else somebody's getting fired.
That's OCD?
40 pairs of bed, you know, okay.
Why would you have 40 pairs?
That's what I don't understand. On average, think about it. Families right now, even a big family, like 5 kids, uh-huh. If you really have a big family.
I have 3. I have a big family.
That's still big. So, on average, each kid is having how many? 5 pairs of bed sheets?
Okay, that's decent.
Jesus Christ.
That's like, decent.
At the end of the Tina, how long is a person supposed to use bed sheets in a week?
3 days tops.
Okay. No, for women. Okay, then for men?
Lol.
No, there's a difference between men and women because women tend to
be 1 month.
Okay, are you talking about cocoa finger also? Because we know there are some men. You know there's a guy. Actually, this is funny.
Okay.
A guy was dropping a hard drive at my place. Mm-hmm. And he phoned me washing the curtains. Mm. He asked me, hey, they wash curtains?
Okay.
He asked
men
me that.
Are from Mars.
Yo, yes, that's it. Simple. They wash curtains. He actually didn't know all
that
his
they
life.
Wash them.
He didn't know. There are even men who don't know that you're supposed to wash like the outside of a saucepan. They don't know. They think you wash only the inside.
Okay, so are we in the president's office here?
No. And we are not only, that's not only men. There are some snake queens that, these Fabiolas.
Hi, Fabiola.
They do that. How many times has Fabiola washed bed sheets in a month?
I doubt.
See?
It's even when I so lazy, they have to buy a new knickers every day.
Eh, okay.
And then they try to brag.
It's doing an hour.
That is laziness.
Me, I think rather than wash, you time yourself. If you're not in the other time, just don't wear.
Just go back naked.
Thank you. Just go live.
I'm a living example. Isn't that okay? It's perfectly okay.
Okay. Anyway. seriously. President Museveni, which country, the country that you preside over, we can't really afford 40 pairs of bed sheets even if we really wanted to.
The second hand of MPR.
MPR?
I'm Peter to the sobola. Going out of supermarket, one good pair of like a good thread count could go up to 1 mil.
So
he needed to be specific.
You use bed sheets of 1 mil?
Thread count matters. Okay. There's bed sheets you go into and you feel like there's tiny little hands brushing you to sleep.
Okay. Now this is a controversial point I have.
Okay.
Also, we have to put in account where the woman comes from.
Ooh.
So like if it's a woman from the
no,
West,
let us not go down. But if it is a woman from the West, he has a valid argument.
You know, but now, women from the North, number 140.
Hey, man, I'm going to go by the way.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, seriously, leave that one.
No, but seriously, very many people have seen that headline.
Yeah.
And they've called me. I had a friend in the States.
Yeah.
He says, I just went on to social and I saw it and I was like, what the? Is this my country? Like, one thing I'm loving about this country, you are giving me a chuckle by the minute.
I'm starting to think that President, you know, President Museveni, I find him one of the most clever leaders.
He's actually very smart.
I think this guy has come to know that to win battles these days, it's not about that gun. Thank you. It's about the social media punchlines.
Oh, yeah.
They work so much.
Big up on yourself, Don Wanyama. You have educated him well.
If you were to break into some safe some safe box in the state house, you probably might find that this whole thing of Fresh Daddy is Museveni's work.
Ew.
No, 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 seriously. Because think about, like, when was the last time Bobi Wine made noise?
No, I could believe.
He's buried.
Where is he? He's not in the country.
Thank you. Like, people don't even know that Bobi Wine, yo. We even have to go for the break.
You know what, Uganda, at times I want to deal, but I will not deal. I've learned how to calm down. Anyway, let's take a short break, and when we do return, more of these stories and a lot much more coming your way.
Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Kufuka bus, no jog. You live one life, think thrice.